still being celebrated.
More copies of that dreadful book. Wherever shall we put them all?
We talked about this, Mary dear. This is my salary from the society. They have nothing else with which to pay me.
If only Mr. Hook and Mr. Newton were more like you.
Hallie and Wren decided to confront Hook about his false claims.
That lore is mine, I tell you. I proved it first.
Then fetch your proof here at once. Let us see it. Surely we have waited on it long enough.
You'll simply have to take my word for it.
Empty claims may persuade elsewhere, but not here. Put up or shut up, Mr. Hook.
Blasted Newton, I'll make him pay.
Wasn't for Edmund Halley, Newton's great book would have never been conceived, nor written, nor printed. Okay, so what? What difference does that make to us? It's the big deal. When Isaac Newton was born in this house in 1642, the world was very different. Everyone looked at the perfection of the clockwork motions of the planets in the sky and could only understand it as the work of a master clockmaker. How else to explain it? There was only one way such a thing could come about in their imagination. Only one answer for them. God. For reasons beyond our understanding, God just created the solar system that way. But this explanation is the closing of a door. It doesn't lead to other questions. Along came Newton, a God-loving man who was also a genius. He could write the laws of nature in perfect mathematical sentences, formulas that applied universally to apples, moons, planets, and so much more.